I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've actually left them.
One day I'm gonna look back and be like, dang, I miss this junk. Like, so sad, so sad. It's crazy I'm a freaking senior. Like, don't you think that's crazy? Well, I look ugly, but.
Bad bitch gang. All the bad bitches. Bad bitch one. Bad bitch two.
When I met you in the question is, what did you learn the last 4 years of your life? I have learned a lot, but the most important things I have learned is life is what you make it. I say, YOLO, you only live once, so do what makes you happy and not others. But you and your mental health first. You come first always. I also learned that people come and go. Do not expect your now friends to be your later friends, or your best friend to be your other friend. It's just a cycle of life, and we have to just accept it for it is what it is. In high school, it is where you learn yourself and learn the real world. It is not always peaches and creams, and it gets worse. You go through emotions you never imagined, but it's all part of the journey. It's rocky, but if you keep your boat afloat, you'll make it. I came into high school with this big High School Musical perspective, and when I tell you, it's nothing that's what I thought. 1 minute is going great, next minute ready to end it all, next minute on top of the world. Learned that school is not hard. You just have to focus and actually do your work. Balance life and school. You do not have to be the smartest in the end. We are all just human beings. Take life slow and trust in God. Have faith.
The next question is, what teacher and classroom experience will I cherish the most? This is going to shock everyone, but even though I did not like Mr. Nogle in the beginning or the end, he is the teacher that I will cherish the most, because once you get to know him, he's actually a nice fellow. And he also taught me to push myself past the limits. Experience I will cherish the most is Mr. Lewis' class and Chef Bradwell's class. Mr. Lewis' class felt like home, and he was the only teacher that I actually learned from and could stand teaching, because he made it interactive and teach in real life perspective. All in all, my experience at GCHS, Gadsden County High School, was a 7. The people at the school made it most challenging, because it's some real people, weird people around here. I think the ones who actually supported me and made my experience worth a while. If you saw yourself, then I'm talking about you. I have one Miss Homecoming for the school, and I would graduate top 20. Could have been top 10 without missing assignments, haha. But anyways, I really only account 3 years of school, because 10th grade year was taken away by COVID. I will never forgive Trump for that. What are my short-term plans post-graduation? As you've seen, I've gotten accepted into the prestigious Florida State University with a full ride, yay. Me, so I will be attending starting this summer, and I'll be getting my real estate license, CNA certification license, all while in school for business and psychology. In 5 years, I see myself traveling, enjoying life, and praising God. I'll be healthy, wealthy, and ghost. I want you guys to remember this moment and mark my words. I'm gonna live past my name and be the queen. But yeah, I feel like, you see me getting accepted? Yeah, baby, I want my pressure, baby. I was too happy because, like, look at me, like, who you know? But, yeah.
This is the last game.
Like, look at all these memories, man. Like, these people I'm not going to see. But I hope I see y'all, but I know I'm not going to see some of y'all. It's going to just hurt. Cause, like, man, I used to wake up every day to see y'all. So I just hope everyone be great and
I look good, don't it? I know.
Everyone.
Ew, it's on my teeth. I'm finna tell.
And everyone just be happy. In Jesus' name, amen.
Ooh, she's finna
have
put that bit. Oh, yeah,
how do you feel like situation could have been prevented?
The situation could have been prevented.
How do you feel like situation could have been in
Good morning, Dad Wilder. Welcome to St. Louis.
This is special dedication to my best friend Noah. I love you and I miss you.
We don't want to see you on booking report. We don't want to see you on booking report. We don't want to see you on booking report. We don't want to see you
at all.
So leave the balance alone.
All right, y'all.
Yes, it's spreading out.
What's up?
22nd. Yeah. Okay, y'all, look at these people. Hopefully we turn out to be great people in life.
Amen.